Thank you. Peace to you, mover of the least. 7 more journeys have moved you closer. I was seduced while in Denis. My humble darkness lasted only a short time before I began to bask in what I could do, what I could write. My gift, my path, the knowledge of my father and the dreams of my mother pierced a hole in the darkness, in the weakness. I was aware of my power and I was proud. Whole worlds at my fingertips. It was the same with the Dani, the same cycle. Light opens the darkness. It takes, it uses, and it keeps. The Dani found power in these books you used to travel. They were a gift from the Maker. These ages you traveled to were their ages. Remarkable places giving life and taking life. This shadow came over them, this shadow of light. For it was in their enlightenment that they considered themselves better. Better than the least. And we were sad for them. Can you feel the Dani there? You've touched the remnants, the remains of their pride and power. Did you see the hidden caves and the cages? It is where the proud would keep the least. The least were only animals, after all. Animals that could link. They could be put to work or play. They could ease the burden of the proud and fill their free time with entertainment. Quietly as Denis slept, their lives were taken because the proud make the rules. This wasn't the first time such a blasphemy was part of Dani. The histories whisper of it, like Fatouk the Aether, or King Asenlef. And even in this age, it may not be the last. The writing hides what's between the lines. These journeys are to help. You return again. Return to hear more. Return for a third pillar. It's an interesting cycle, this coming and going. Giving and taking. Returning is what you must do. For you have torn in half the very being of one of the least. You have heard their pain. Don't falter. Let me tell you of King Carath. Dare I speak ill of him? One of the great kings, but yet he was the maker of the proud, for it was his system of guilds that served as the foundation of power and corruption. The powerful need control, fortresses and garrisons to guard their power, and soon the guarding is yet another thing to be proud of. Layers within layers built to preserve their ages and their pride from the weak and least who might attack from without. And yet, it is from within that most nations fall. And so the mighty garrisons of Denis now stand vacant. The people of Denis didn't return easily. They only would take until all was taken from them in the great returning, the fall that destroyed them. Denis fell only a few hundred years ago. All of it was removed. And my journey was similar. I could write things that no Denis had ever dreamed of. My writing smashed barriers held as absolutes for millennia. I could change things, I could move things. I could control things. I learned beyond my parents, I learned beyond all. I rode ages against any challengers, masters of the art, and they were beaten. I took all that I could hold. Only death can conquer pride so strong. For the Denis and for Yisha, it was death that moved me to return. All died. All but the least. The unproud. The Bahro considered themselves as dead already. And so they continued to watch Denis, always ready to give more away. And now they will return.